Hello everyone, so welcome back to Kalamayas Academy. GS paper 2 of the UPSC mains 2024 has been conducted, and those who has given mains, please comment that how has been the paper, how much heat did you feel in this paper, because this paper in general was bit tougher inside from the 2023, and most importantly the 10 marker one, right? 15 marker questions was relatively doable, so that was the. So we will be analyzing this paper along with the trend analysis compared to the previous year questions for the polity, governance and social justice portion. That is around 200, not around, that is exactly 200 marks out of the 250 marks, because 50 marks is for the international relation. So let's see this. Every one of you, whether you have written mains or not, if you are UPSC aspirant, you must be knowing these are the syllabus of polity in our UPSC exam, right? So I will not be going into the too much details because you already know about this. Now regarding the trends of marks which is there inside our polity sections, so since last 5-6 years, if you will see, then you will find that the marks have been hovering from 115 to 135 marks, right? Because from 2018 to 2021, like to 2018, 19, 20, it was 115 marks. In 2021, it was 125 marks. 122, it was 125 marks. Last year, there was one 10 marker more. So, 135 marks question was there from the polity section. But again, back to the normal, UPSC has come back and UPSC has asked around 125 marks question in 2024 this year. Among this 125 marks question, so 5 question is of the 10 marks and 5 question is of the 15 marks. So that all together is of the 125 marks question, and this has been a general trend of the UPSC, right? Now let's see what has been the level of question this year, because there has been several terms which emerged in the question paper, which is generally UPSC aspirants are not actually aware or not very much knowledgeable about that, ठीक है? तो उसको देखते हैं. ये है आपका UPSC 2024 का questions, that is 10 marker question in the polity section. So definitely you will see that the keywords from the UPSC syllabus is appearing in the question paper, and more importantly, the question paper is tilted towards the current, right? There are two portions, that is static portion as well as the current portion. So the static, this portion is more tilted towards the current side, right? And therefore it is like bit trickier or the bit means tougher sides from the 2023 paper, because that was more of the static types of, that was tilted towards the static portion. ठीक है. So question number one nation one election, all of you know that this former president Ramnath Kovind committee was set up for this simultaneous election, one nation one election, and therefore this question, so this was pretty much doable in nature. Question number two, that is explain and distinguish between the Lok Adalat, arbitration tribunals, whether they entertain civil as well as the criminal cases. So this has been the favorite topic of UPSC in recent years. Like the, in last year, the question has been free legal aid and questions regarding the NALSA. This year, they have asked about the Lok Adalat and the arbitral tribunals. So that is there. Question number three. So again, this question can also be done because there is not much of current linked things is there. So static, with the static knowledge, you will be able to solve this question, and that every UPSC aspirants means read, even for the prelims as well as for the mains point of view. The question number 3, the growth of cabinet system has practically resulted in the marginalization of the parliamentary supremacy, elucidate. So again, this question, there has been the growth of this cabinet system. Instead of the Council of States, the cabinet system has emerged as more powerful. So this cabinet system, and because of this, there is parliamentary supremacy. So how that has been there, that you have to elucidate, means with some kinds of examples and some kinds of facts, you have to elaborate this part. So that is also static in nature, but you will be needing the current examples, right? Static knowledge will be required, but along with that, how this cabinet system has emerged newly, that is practically how this is involving this parliamentary supremacy, that is required. Then the duty of the CAG is not merely to ensure the legality of the expenditure, but also its propriety. So CAG topic, again, it keeps on appearing in 2-3 years again and again in the UPSC mains paper. So that person is also there. So here there was one thing, that this propriety. So many a times the UPSC aspirants may not be knowing this term. Even you have some guess about this term, so that will solve, not but much a big deal was there. That question number 5, it was like a guess question only. Like, analyze the role of the local bodies in providing good governance at the local level and bring out the pros and cons merging the rural local bodies with the urban local bodies. But first part is very much doable, that everyone's prepared. But the second part, this is very innovative part, ki kya hoga agar urban local bodies and the local, jo rural local bodies hai, usko merge kar diya jayega, to uske kya pros hain, uske kya cons hain. अब ये एग्जाम प्रेशर में ये वाला पार्ट बहुत टफ हो जाता है, राइट? बिकॉज देयर आर 73rd कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट, देयर आर 74th कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट, एंड बोथ दिस पार्ट आर सेपरेट करेंटली. अब अगर इसको मर्ज कर दिया जाए तो उसका क्या प्रोज होगा, क्या कॉन्स होगा? सो थिंकिंग दिस पार्ट इज रिलेटिवली मच टफर इन द एग्जाम प्रेशर, बिकॉज ये जनरली स्टूडेंट्स नहीं सोच के जाते हैं. सो दिस पर्सन इज वेरी टफ, बट फर्स्ट पर्सन can be done. Now coming to the 15 marker question in the polity section. So this 15 marker question is, again, it is a mixed bag of static as well as the current, and a mixed bag of the moderate as well as the tougher part, right? The current linked questions are more of the tougher parts. So question number 6, what are the aim and objective of recently passed enforced the public examination prevention of unfair means act 2024? So this act everyone must have read, all the UPSC aspirants, I expect that, as lots of hue and cry was there regarding the NEET scam, right? So therefore, after that, this public examination prevention of unfair means act 2024 came, and this was very much in news. So this was an expected question. And to answer the second part, you have to know exactly what is there inside the act. You cannot do a guesswork over here, right? So ye wala part thoda sa tougher ho jayega, but if you know the features of this act, that part can also be solved. Then question number 7. Now right to privacy coming under the Article 21, that is right to life and personal liberty. Now this Article 21, in recent years have become a favorite of the UPSC. Last year also this right to life and personal liberty appeared in the exam, right? So that is there, right to privacy, Article 21 in the Constitution, right to intrinsic of the life and personal liberty and inherently protected under the Article 21 of the Constitution, explain. So how Article right to privacy is inherent, that you have to explain. And in this reference, discuss the law relating to the testing of the child in the womb to establish its paternity, right? Now this portion of the question is very tough in the exam process, because bahut jyada points exam pressure mein nahi yaad aayega DNA testing se, right? To ye problem hai. And first wale portion mein bhi right to privacy, logo ko bas pata hota hai ki right to privacy Article 21 hai, आर्टिकल 21 के अंदर राइट टू प्राइवेसी आता है, बट उसको प्रॉपरली एक्सप्लेन करना इज अगेन इट इज टफर. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 इज बिट टफर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, नाउ दिस कैन बी ए वेरी कॉमन क्वेश्चन, स्टैटिक नेचर. What changes has the Union Government recently introduced in the domain of the central-state relation? So here in this part, you will be needing the value addition from the current affairs. So even that is easier because you have to identify the central-state relation and recalling 7-8 points for the central-state relation where there has been clashes or where there has been the Union Government taking decisions for the states. So that is not a big deal. Suggest measures adopted to be adopted to build the trust between the center and the states and strengthening the federalism. So this is a common question everyone prepares, that what should be there better, how federalism can be there, how cooperative federalism, how competitive federalism, how that can be done. So that answer you have to write. Question number 9, explain the reason for the growth of public interest litigation in India, and as a result of it, has the Indian Supreme Court emerged as the world's most powerful judiciary, right? Now this question is very analytical in nature. First you have to understand that what is public interest litigation, from when this public interest litigation came, what was the scenario because of this PIL came, because it came during the 1975-1976 times. Right, first time it was implemented during the 1979, right. So all those facts, all those data you will be requiring to explain this thing in very much detail, right. So again, not an easy question. Question number 10, so comparative analysis. Last year there has been comparative analysis of the India and the Britain, that is parliamentary sovereignty wala question was there. This year they have asked about the comparative analysis of the India and the USA. So now all UPSC aspirants, at least they are preparing for two kinds of comparative analysis with the two countries. Means Britain or USA to prepare karke jaate hi. So last year Britain pucha tha, is saal USA puch liya. So not a big deal. Secular state, jo secularism ka jo concept hai, Western secular model and Indian secular model, that is arm's length distance model and the principal distance model, usi ko achhe se explain karna hai. So this question is also static types and it can also be done. So overall you can find that there has been a mix of questions between the static as well as the current, and there were moderate questions. Easy to nahi hai. राइट, एग्जाम प्रेशर में कुछ भी इजी नहीं होता वहाँ पर, जब आपको 4,500 वर्ड्स एंड 20 क्वेश्चंस लिखने हो, सो देर इज नथिंग इजी, बट स्टिल सम क्वेश्चंस वे आर मॉडरेट एंड दे आर डूएबल इजीली, बट सम क्वेश्चंस आर बिट टफर साइड्स एंड दोज क्वेश्चंस कैन बी हैंडल्ड ओनली इफ यू हैव ए गुड नॉलेज अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट, अबाउट द कॉन्टेंट. सो दैट इज देयर. नाउ that was the portion of polity section, that was 125 marks of the question. Now coming to the governance and social justice portion, if you bifurcate the governance part and the social justice part, so you will find that in the governance part these are the syllabus, that is government policy intervention development process, role of NGO, SHGs, donor agencies, governance, transparency, accountability, e-governance, role of civil services and democracy. So these are the syllabus under the governance portion. From this portion of the syllabus, if you compare, then the past trend have shown that around like the questions have been hovering from the governance portion, that is sometimes the questions asked were of 55 marks, sometimes 35 marks, sometimes 45 marks, sometimes 35 marks. This year there has been 50 marks question from the governance portion, and that is huge because combinedly governance and the social justice portion, they ask around 75 marks question, right, and that is a general trend. So around 75 to 80 marks question they generally asked from this both section, that is governance and the social justice portion. This year they have given higher weightage to the governance portion, And they asked around, that is 50 marks question from the governance person only. And that 50 marks question is constituting of the 4 question, 2 question from the 10 marker and 2 question from the 15 marker. So, all together this constituted 50 marks, right. Now, these are the questions which they have asked in governance portion. The question number 1 itself was very tough, because the UPSC has never asked questions from this trust and all. Actually, this Waqf board was very much in news, right, and that is also some kinds of these kinds of religious organizations, right. So, public, the first question itself, the public charitable trust have the potential to make India's development more inclusive as they relate to certain vital issues comment. Now, this question UPSC aspirants generally do not prepare, right, because questions has not been asked earlier from this topic. The trust portion has not been asked earlier. So, UPSC aspirants do not have enough knowledge for this question, right. So, handling this question was relatively tougher sides, or I would say that it was very tough in exam process to generate around 7-8 good points in this part. So, question number, generic point everyone can write, right. I am not talking about the generic points. Generic points, all the UPSC aspirants, they will be able to write the generic points, even if they know the definition of the trust and if they know what the trust means, right. But I am telling that the quality points, generating quality points, that is 7-8 points or the 10 points, you have to generate in the exam pressure and you have to write this question in the 7 minutes. So, in that respect, it becomes very tough, right. Generically, you can handle this. Then the question of question number 2. That was also a 10 marker question. The doctrine of democratic governance makes it necessary that the public perception of the integrity and commitment of the civil servants become absolutely positive. Discuss. So, this doctrine of democratic governance, now this terms everyone may not be knowing, and the thing is, you will be guessing, but with this democratic governance, there is nothing new which will be coming up. So, even the guesswork will work over here. So, the doctrine of democratic governance makes it necessary that the public perception of the integrity and commitments of the civil servants becomes absolutely positive. Discuss. So, this question, it will take few seconds, right. It will take few seconds to interpret this question. So, in that manner, the for the interpretation of the question, this question becomes tougher. Once you interpret the question with cool mind, then the question becomes easier. So, interpreting this question was tougher. Question number 3, this was very ghisapita type of question. Like, the citizen charter has been landmark initiative in the ensuring citizen-centric administration, but it is yet to reach its full potential. Identify the factors hindering the realization of the promises and suggest measures to overcome them. तो ये सब सारा कुछ जो सिटीजन चार्टर से रिलेटेड आप यही क्वेश्चन प्रिपेयर करते हो, राइट. ऑल द यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स प्रिपेयर फॉर द सिटीजन चार्टर एंड दे प्रिपेयर ओनली फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन, राइट. सो अभी भी बहुत सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन आया है, सिटीजन चार्टर वाला क्वेश्चन. आई कैन से दैट दिस इज रिलेटिवली इजियर. अगर कोई भी सिटीजन चार्टर टॉपिक प्रिपेयर किया है तो आसानी से ये क्वेश्चन लिखा जा सकता है. एंड ई गवर्नेंस टॉपिक इज अगेन वेरी favorite for the UPSC. Last year also e-governance has appeared. This again e-governance has appeared once again in this paper also. So, the question reads that the e-governance is not just about the routine application of the digital technology in such delivery process. It is as much about multifarious interaction for the ensuring transparency and accountability. In this context, evaluate the role of interactive service model of the e-governance. Now, the aspirants may panic in exam pressure, that is, what is this interactive service model, right. This word, maybe that they may not have heard this word before the exam hall, right. So, that manner this question again become a bit tougher while interpreting this, but once you generalize, even you have the general understanding that what is this interactive service model, that will be a participative model only. Once you understand this thing, then course there is nothing in the question which you cannot do. So that you can find over here that there has been some tricky parts in the question. While interpreting the question itself, you will find lots of difficulty in exam hall, right. So Gavardhan's portion was little tougher from the last year. The last year's questions was like easier ones, and it was doable easily, right. It was easily interpretable and usko aaram se kiya ja sakta tha. But is saal thoda sa bit tougher hai governance wala portion. So that is there. Now question, to ye to tha governance portion se. Now coming to the social justice portion. Social justice portion, if you look at the syllabus, so these are the syllabus, that is welfare schemes for the vulnerable sections, various institutions and bodies regarding that, then issues regarding the health, education, human resource and poverty and hunger related issues. So these are the topics which are coming under the social justice portion. Is wale topic se agar aap dekhoge to again yahan par 35 40 30 40 35 number ke questions aate rahe hain. Actually governance and social justice dono mila ke 75 marks ka question aata raha, kabhi kabhi 80 bhi chala jata hai. So that has been there. So around like 2020 it was 40 marks, then 2021 35 marks, then again 40 marks, then 30 marks. This year only there has been two questions from this section, that is one 10 marker question and another 15 marker question. So that makes that it is of the 25 marks paper, that is from the social justice portion. And the question from here, if you read that question number 1, poverty and malnutrition creates a vicious cycle adversely affecting human capital formation, what steps can be taken to break the cycle? So again this question is very much basic, very much doable. You will have lots of data, facts, examples regarding the poverty and malnutrition. Several reports are there, several indexes are there, so you have lots of knowledge regarding this question. And also regarding the human capital formation also you have lots of data, facts, examples, so that is there. UPSC aspirants generally have prepared this topic, so there should not be any problem in dealing this question, that is question number 1st of the social justice portion. Now question number 2nd, that is in a crucial domain like the public health care system, the Indian state should play a vital role in containing the adverse impact of the marketization, now marketization of the system. Suggest some measures through which the state can enhance the reach of the public health care at the grassroots. So again, second part is very simple. So that is simply that how the health care system can be improved. So that you have to write. Again, the first part, in interpreting the question itself, you will find a bit difficulty. Because here the what does this mean, the adverse impact of the marketization of the system. So you will need few seconds over there, right. That is basically talking about the role of the private sector organization in the health sectors. So that is getting more marketized, right. So that angle you have to take into the consideration over here, right. So the question was not direct, you have to interpret this word. So this interpretation of the word will require few seconds, or even in case it may take 1 minute also for the aspirant. Once you understand the question properly, so it is very much doable, it can be done, right. So that has been the social justice portion. So you can see that out of the 250 marks question, out of the 250 marks GS paper 2, the 200 marks of the polity, governance and the social justice portion. So there was a mixed bag of questions, and in the exam hall that this is not easier to move from the moderate question to the tougher question, and that too interpreting each parts, because you have to interpret each parts and write all the parts in chronology in your microstructuring of the answer. So that was not easier one, and I would say that compared to the 2022 questions, it was relatively tougher inside. These 200 marks were relatively tougher compared to the 2023. The 2023 questions, So you can see that the questions were like the judicial independence, then free legal aid. I had told you that the free legal aid was question there, NALSA was there. This time, like Lok Adalat, they have asked, right? Lok Adalat is also being set up through the NALSA only. So this things have changed. Then urban local bodies, same theme was repeated again, because there has been the merging of the local bodies. That question is there currently. Parliamentary sovereignty, last year Britain and India comparative politics was asked. This year, like USA and India has been asked. So that is there. Role of the presiding officers, Competition Commission of India. So instead of this Competition Commission of India, this CAG has appeared, and that was, CAG is always in the news. So all the UPSC aspirants keep on preparing this CAG. Then again this question 2023, right to life and personal liberty. This question again appeared in the right to life and personal liberty, again appeared in 2024 also, in terms of right to privacy, right? So that article 21 has become a favorite of the UPSC. Then gender justice was there. This year the gender justice has appeared in the Indian society portion, that is gender equality, gender equity, women empowerment. So that theme has appeared in the Indian society portion. So you can see that the something which has been asked last year in polity section, so same thing, same theme has been asked this year in the Indian society portion. So aisa compartmentalization of the subject nahi kiya ja sakta ki sirf polity padh ke society ke answers nahi likhenge, society padh ke polity ke answers nahi likhenge, aisa nahi hoga. Knowledge, you will have the broad knowledge about whole syllabus, and kisi bhi syllabus ka part kahin pe bhi use hoga, that will be there. Then article 56 was there, parliamentary committee system. So all these things was there in the question last year. If you see the governance, so governance portion was relatively easier side, because yahan par aisa kuch bhi nahi aapko dikhega jisme question samajhne mein problem ho gaya ho, right, 2023 mein. But governance question and especially 10 marker question in this 2024 was bit tougher side compared to the 2023, right? To samajhne mein time lag raha tha. Ek bar agar aap samajh jaoge to fir cheeze handle kiye ja sakte hain. But one question was there, that was the trust one questions, so charitable trust question, usko aasani se handle nahi kiya ja sakta tha. Jiske paas knowledge hoga wahi quality content create kar sakte hain. Then regarding the social justice portion, last year there was the development and the welfare schemes, skill development program, so these were also easier sides. So overall in last year in 2023, if you see the question paper was easier, aisa koi terms nahi tha in polity, governance, social justice portion, jo ki means UPSC aspirant ko kuch der soch ke sochne ke liye baithna pade ki kya matlab hoga iska. जैसे यहाँ पर आ रहा है डॉक्ट्राइन ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नेंस, राइट, तो अब ये थोड़ा देर सोचना पड़ेगा कि ये क्या लिखना है इसमें, है ना. सो इस टाइप का क्वेश्चन 2023 में नहीं था. इसके करस्पॉन्डिंग ऐसा कहा जा सकता है कि दिस ईयर द पेपर हैज बीन रिलेटिवली बिट टफर फ्रॉम द 2023 पोर्शन. लास्ट ईयर 2023 में स्टैटिक पोर्शन का टिल्ट थोड़ा ज़्यादा था, इस साल करेंट अफेयर्स का टिल्ट थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा है, तो उस मैटर में भी ये थोड़ा सा टफ हो जाता है 2024 का पेपर करस्पॉन्डिंग टू 2020. नाउ व्हाट शुड बी योर अप्रोच फॉर द 2025? अब करे तो करे क्या, राइट? सो एज यू कैन सी दैट द थीम्स हैव बीन रिपीटिंग, राइट, एंड व्हाट एवर इज देयर इनसाइड द सिलेबस, सेम थिंग इज अपीयरिंग आइदर इन द स्टैटिक पोर्शन और इन द करेंट अफेयर, करेंट इशूज पोर्शन, दैट इज डायनामिक पोर्शन. तो दोनों ही पोर्शन अगर आप कर लेते हैं, सो यू विल बी एबल टू हैंडल द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपरली. सो व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड, दैट यू हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ करेंट इशूज, क्या चल रहा है वो डेफिनेटली यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स पढ़ते हैं ये सब चीज़ें, राइट. सो दैट यू हैव विल हैव टू कंटिन्यू फॉर द 2025 एज वेल. प्रिपेयर ऑल द कीवर्ड्स ऑफ द सिलेबस. As you can see that the keywords are appearing again and again. ऐसा कोई keywords नहीं है question के अंदर जो UPSC syllabus के अंदर ही नहीं दे रखा, right? So if you prepare, if your preparation is around the keywords of the UPSC syllabus, so your preparation will be complete by that. सारे कीवर्ड्स को कर लो, उसके अराउंड जो है स्टैटिक पोर्शन का जो नॉलेज रिक्वायर्ड है वो कर लो, एंड जो करंट इशूज उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग जो चल रहा है वो कर लो. सो दैट इज वट यू हैव टू डू, स्टिक टू द सिलेबस. देन प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन, इट बिकम्स ए बाइबल गीता कुरान, लाइक अगेन एंड अगेन आई एम सेइंग दिस दैट इट बिकम्स ए बाइबल गीता कुरान फॉर यू, बिकॉज सब कुछ यहीं पर छिपा है, सारा नॉलेज यहीं पर छिपा है. राइट, कुछ क्वेश्चन इनोवेटिव हो सकता है, कुछ क्वेश्चन जो है ऐसा होगा दैट यू विल नॉट बी नोइंग, बट रेस्ट ऑफ द थीम्स यू कैन डायरेक्टली गेस फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. वो डायरेक्टली वहाँ से आ रहा है, वही अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज, वही पार्लियामेंट, वही सुप्रीम कोर्ट्स. राइट, तो ये सब चीज़ें जो हैं वो प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन के थीम रिपीट होते हैं. सो कंसिडर दिस एज ए बाइबल, और इसको अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करो, देखो कि किस टॉपिक से किस तरह के क्वेश्चन पूछे जा रहे हैं. सिमिलर ट्रेंड्स इज बीइंग फॉलोड. थोड़ा सा क्वेश्चन जो है वो टफ हो सकता है, थोड़ा सा मॉडरेट हो सकता है, थोड़ा सा इजी हो सकता है, बट थीम्स वही रिपीट हो रहे हैं जो प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस में ऑलरेडी पूछा गया है. देन राइटिंग ओनली द जेनरिक पॉइंट्स इज नॉट सफिशियंट. ऑल द 14,000 स्टूडेंट्स हु आर राइटिंग मीन्स दे नो जेनरिक पॉइंट्स. राइट, they are so much knowledgeable, they have cleared the prelims. So if you are writing only the generic points in your answers, that is not sufficient, you will not be getting like above average marks. Right, or you will be getting very poor marks if you are writing the generic points. हाँ, किसी क्वेश्चन को अब बिल्कुल भी हवा ही नहीं लग रहा, तो in that question you can write generic points, so that is much better than leaving the question. Right, so in that question it will work, but overall you will have to write फीडर मटेरियल्स, दैट इज डाटा, फैक्ट्स, एग्जाम्पल्स, सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजमेंट्स, देन दिस कमिटी रिकमेंडेशंस. देर आर सेवरल कमिटीज रिगार्डिंग द पॉलिटी सेक्शंस. दिस ईयर ऑल्सो द कमिटी हैज बीन आस्ड. देन दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल आर्टिकल्स. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स विच यू हैव टू इंक्लूड इन योर आंसर टू राइट ए बेटर आंसर, सो दैट योर आंसर विल बी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड फ्रॉम द अदर एस्पिरेंट्स. वाई वुड द एग्जामिनर विल गिव यू means 1 marks, 1.5 marks or 2 marks, 3 marks extra from the other aspirants. Right, you will have to write extra things within the word limit. So you will have to understand this, you will have to work for this. And for that, for preparing this current issue, so newspaper is always there. Along with that, any monthly magazine you can follow, that is from the any coaching institutes. We also release this now, so you can also follow that. So you can do from there itself. And the most important portion, that is answer writing. Problem ये हो रहा है कि UPSC aspirants लिख ही नहीं पा रहे, all the 20 questions लिख ही नहीं पा रहे, या उनके पास capacity ही नहीं है कि वो 4,000 4,500 words 3 घंटे के अंदर लिख पाए. ये बहुत बड़ी problem. अगर आपने 2 क्वेश्चन 3 क्वेश्चन छोड़ दिया हर एक पेपर में, तो वहीं सिलेक्शन रुक जाता है. राइट, सो आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू ट्रेन योर माइंड. 20 क्वेश्चन इन 3 आवर्स, हाउ डू यू राइट लाइक 10 मार्कर क्वेश्चन इन 7 मिनट्स, हाउ डू यू राइट दिस 15 मार्कर क्वेश्चन इन 11 मिनट्स, दैट यू विल हैव टू माइंड. ये चीज ऐसे नहीं माइंड मैप करने से प्रैक्टिस सही आएगा. Right, so answer writing is very, very, very important. No matter how much knowledgeable you are, if you are not able to write, if you are not able to recall during the exam pressure, what is the use of that knowledge? Right, so answer writing practice you have to do. So this is the complete cycle you have to follow for the 2025 mains for the polity, governance and the social justice portion. Right, I hope you will be doing. Then one information is that जो 14,000 हुआ मेन्स लिख रहे हैं, UPSC मेन्स, सेम UPSC मेन्स का पेपर we will be conducting. आके लिख सकते हो एग्जाम, आप अपना ऑनलाइन सबमिट कर सकते हो. सो सेम थिंग वी आर कंडक्टिंग ऑन द सेम डे, जैसे आज GS पेपर 1 GS पेपर 2 हुआ, तो आज ही हम लोगों ने जीएस पेपर वन जीएस टू कंडक्ट करवा लिया है। अगर आप आज नहीं दे पाए हो, यू कैन स्टिल इनरोल एंड यू कैन गिव मिस लेटर ऑन ऑल्सो। द होल पर्पस ऑफ दिस एक्टिविटी इज दैट यू शुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द हीट, एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट आर द थिंग्स व्हिच यू आर लैकिंग इन योर प्रिपरेशन रिगार्डिंग द मेंस। अगर आप यहाँ नहीं लिखोगे इस साल, तो हो सकता है अगले साल प्रीलिम्स क्लियर करो और अगले साल मेंस लिख के आपको पता चलेगा कि क्या प्रॉब्लम है। अगर अभी पता चल जाएगा तो अगले साल तक आप ठीक कर लिए रहोगे एंड यू विल बी गेटिंग द रैंक। दैट इज द होल पर्पस ऑफ दिस रिप्ले प्रोग्राम। लाइव सेशंस तो यूपीएससी जो एग्जाम हॉल में कंडक्ट करवा रही है वो चल रहा है, हम लोग तो रिप्ले ही करवा सकते हैं। जो क्वेश्चन पेपर आ गया है वो क्वेश्चन पेपर आपको मिलेगा, यू विल बी राइटिंग दिस टेस्ट एंड वी विल बी डूइंग द फेस टू फेस इवेल्युएशन प्रोवाइडेड विद द मॉडल आंसर्स एंड ऑल्सो डिस्कशंस विल ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडेड यू, राइट। सो आई होप यू विल बी राइटिंग, डू नॉट निग्लेक्ट दिस एक्टिविटी, इज वेरी वेरी हेल्पफुल। बहुत सारे टॉपर्स ऐसे हैं जिनका प्रीलिम्स क्लियर नहीं हुआ था एंड बाद में उन्होंने ये प्रैक्टिस किया ड्यूरिंग द मेंस टाइम एंड दे गॉट वेरी बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम दिस, नेक्स्ट ईयर दे गॉट रैंक। सो व्हाई डोंट यू ऑल्सो डू दिस, राइट? आइडेंटिफाइंग योर मिस्टेक्स ऑफ द मेंस एट दिस करेंट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इज वेरी मच रिक्वायर्ड। एक साल बर्बाद करने के बाद ये पता चल के कोई फायदा नहीं है, एक साल बर्बाद हो जाएगा। So that was all from my side regarding the trend analysis. So what do you feel about the paper and how much difficulty, if you have written the mains, how much difficulty it was there during the exam hall, because exam hall ke andar jo pressure hota hai, jo heat hota hai, wo bahut different hota hai, exam hall ke bahar wala usko feel nahi kar sakta. So you can only tell, and rest also all the aspirants who are watching it, so please do comment that what is your take on this kind of paper after 2024. So that is all from my side in this session. So stay tuned, we will be meeting up with the further discussions also. So thank you very much.